The post-gasoline era is being preceded by new EV models across the globe. Hyundai, Volvo, Kia, Jeep, Mercedes-Benz are introducing new electric vehicles, more efficient, with higher batteries and advances in technology. In this episode, we look at five electric SUVs that will be in full-scale production in 2023 or 2024 and might lead in their segments. Kia EV9. This will be a boxy, off-road capable three-row SUV, ultimately an electric version of the World Car of the Year award-winning Kia Telluride SUV. The Kia concept EV9 is boxier than the Telluride. Compared to the Telluride, it's an inch taller, 3 inches shorter lengthwise, and 3 inches wider. The wheelbase is 7.8 inches longer. Kia has ambitious plans to launch 14 new EVs, not all for the American market, by 2026. The EV9 will be the next version to follow the EV6. Kia confirmed the EV9 will make a world premiere in Q1 of 2023. That would track with a launch later in 2023 as a 2024 model year vehicle. Kia revealed photos of camouflaged EV9 SUVs undergoing final testing in South Korea before the vehicle's official release. The testing included what Kia described as grueling off-road testing. The production body shape looks like it's drawn heavily from the concept, without the extreme wheel proportions. The EV9 will run on Hyundai Group's Electric Global Modular Platform, EGMP, a dedicated platform for electric vehicles that underpins the EV6 and the Hyundai Ioniq 5. The flat floor and lack of a combustion engine and drivetrain components should allow the EV9 ample, flexible interior cabin space and a long wheelbase with short overhangs. If outputs mirror the all-wheel drive EV6, the EV9 will produce 320 horsepower and 446 pound-feet, or 605 newton-meters, of torque, and potentially 576 horsepower and 545 pound-feet, or 740 newton-meters, in high-performance GT guise. It should be able to accomplish the 0-60 sprint in around 6 seconds. Battery size is expected to be 77.4 kilowatt-hour capacity. Kia has said the EV9 will offer a maximum range of about 336 miles, or 540 kilometers, and should be capable of accelerating from 0-60 miles per hour in 5 seconds in top spec. The concept EV9 features a single 27-inch digital display instead of a distinct instrument and infotainment cluster. It is expected that the starting price will be around $50,000. Volvo EX90. Volvo's transition to an all-electric lineup continues with the introduction of a new 7-seater SUV, the EX90. It will be serving as an electric counterpart to Volvo's popular 3-row flagship, the XC90, a 496 horsepower and 671 pound-feet, or 910 newton-meters, of torque electric powertrain with a dual-motor all-wheel drive will be in more powerful model. Volvo expects the EX90 to deliver up to 300 miles, 483 kilometers, of range on a single charge, with its 111 kilowatt-hour battery. The entry level with a dual motor and all-wheel drive will have 408 horsepower. Acceleration should be brisk, even though the EX90 will likely tip the scales at a higher curb weight than its gasoline-powered analog. Volvo says the twin-motor model should be capable of hitting 60 miles per hour in 5.7 seconds, while the twin-motor performance should do the deed in 4.7 seconds. Volvo has said that the EX90 will also showcase the brand's next-generation driver assistance technology, including a new driver monitoring system that can take action to help the driver if it detects distress or distraction. It will be capable in bi-directional charging, allowing the EX90 to send power back out of the vehicle from its battery. Volvo says EX90 deliveries will begin in early 2024, and notes that it will be built in America and available, well-equipped, under $80,000. Mercedes-Benz EQE SUV. With a smooth, rounded appearance, this electric SUV doesn't look like other modern crossovers, most of which pump themselves up with rugged design cues. Instead, the EQE SUV leans on its aerodynamics to help maximize its driving range, which is expected to come in at around 300 miles, or 484 kilometers, per charge, with a 90.6 kilowatt-hour battery pack. The EQE 350 SUV comes with a 288 horsepower electric powertrain, while the EQE 500 is more performance-oriented, with 536 horsepower on tap. Both variants are said to provide similar performance, with the rear-wheel drive hitting 60 miles per hour in a claimed 6.3 seconds, and the all-wheel drive getting there in 6.2 seconds. Upgrading to the EQE 500 bumps combined output of the two electric motors way up to 536 ponies. That's enough to propel the EQE 500 SUV to 60 miles per hour in 4.6 seconds. The EQE SUV will join the market in early 2023. The EQE SUVs will attempt to wow with technology features, including a dashboard full of digital screens, and options such as rear-wheel steering and biometric driver authentication. It shares its platform, styling cues, and interior features with the EQE sedan, but it comes with high riding seating position that so many drivers prefer. The entry-level EQE 350 Plus is expected to be the one with the longest driving range, and more miles equals less range anxiety. Its performance should be similar to the all-wheel drive EQE 350 4MATICs, since they both make the same horsepower. Mercedes equips all models with a generous list of standard equipment. Even the base model comes with a panoramic sunroof, interior ambient lighting, a Burmeister stereo system, and Dolby Atmos tuning, and an array of driver assistance features. The price for the GLS 450 model starts at around $80,000. Hyundai Ioniq 7. Hyundai considers the 2024 Ioniq 7 concept a living space on wheels, which is exactly what the all-electric SUV looks like. Said to be similar in size to the three-row Hyundai Palisade, it rides on the company's new cross-brand eGMP platform, which will underpin the Ioniq 5 and many other upcoming Hyundai and Kia EV models. While its enormous coach doors and furniture-like seats are other fantastical features, the idea of a vast interior with flexible configurations is conceivable. The 2024 Ioniq 7 targets a range of over 300 miles and exceptionally quick charging times. The Hyundai Ioniq 7 will come in two-wheel drive and all-wheel drive configurations. The all-wheel drive variant will offer a system power of 308 horsepower. A 100 kilowatt-hour battery pack will supply electricity to the motors, and the car will offer a ground clearance of more than 8 inches. This three-row SUV is targeting a driver range that exceeds 300 miles or 483 kilometers. It is estimated that the price will start at around $50,000. Jeep Wagoneer S electric vehicle. Jeep has confirmed the Wagoneer S will be an all-electric vehicle with a top range of 400 miles on a single charge. Jeep is targeting an output of 600 horsepower and a 0 to 60 miles per hour time of 3.5 seconds. Jeep says it will have standard 4x4 capability and come with an all-terrain management system. The 2024 Wagoneer EV will be the first electric model from Jeep, though it will draw inspiration from the brand's current gasoline-powered models. This blend of modern and traditional styling elements gives the Wagoneer EV a futuristic look, but it is still recognizable as a Jeep. According to Jeep, production is set to start sometime in 2024. It's estimated that the price will start at around $80,000. Thanks for the visit. Please subscribe and hit the bell button on for more informative automotive videos. Stay tuned.